My name is Dr. Mitchell Fogelson. I just recently successfully defended my PhD in the Mechanical Engineering Department, looking at large deployable space structures for artificial gravity. We've invented different types of scissor units, such as the pop-up extending truss structure. This is a novel scissor mechanism that stows flat when stowed and then pops up into this triangular truss. These structures, when combined hierarchically, allow us to support super high extension ratio space systems for next generation long duration missions. The work that we were looking at for zero G is understanding how we can leverage new simulation tools and real world data to construct digital twins that most accurately represent how our structures are going to behave in a zero gravity environment.
I'm Zac Manchester. I'm an assistant professor in the Robotics Institute at Carnegie Mellon. And my lab is called the Robotics Exploration Lab, or REX Lab for short. We do a whole bunch of things with a primary focus on space exploration. So recently, we were super lucky to get a project on very large deployable space structures funded by NIAC. It's NASA Innovative Advanced Concepts. That's this kind of high-risk blue sky projects within NASA. We did so well in this phase two effort, actually, that we were awarded a zero-G test flight campaign from the NASA Flight Opportunities Office to take some of these structures up on a zero-G flight and try to deploy them in real zero-G. One of the main concerns with a structure like this, with so many moving pieces, so many joints, is that they can jam. That's a huge concern with things that when you get to this level of complexity. And it's basically impossible to simulate the full spinning deployment dynamics of something like this in a 1G test environment.
So we built a miniature motion capture system that consisted of 8 GoPro high-speed cameras and 4 OptiTrack cameras that measure and track IR markers. And so what you're seeing here is actually the IR markers for the polar deployable scissor mechanism as it kind of curves around and the data that we were able to capture. I've been leveraging a lot of the resources through the CMU Schwartz Center and CMU's entrepreneurship network to commercialize these products through my company Beyond Reach Labs. Next year, after I finished my PhD, I'll be staying here in Pittsburgh to continue to develop intelligent architectures for deployable infrastructure for defense, disaster relief, events, and other space applications.